What's up, guys? My name is Master Gamer, and welcome to a much calmer video on the channel where we're going to be talking about Avatar: A Bender's Will. Yes, I said talking about. I know it's something a little different, but I've been following the hell out of this game. If you guys haven't been paying attention, every time Eternal and Envy drop a game, I am on that crap. And A Bender's Will is no different. Matter of fact, it is the biggest one I've been excited for. But here today, we're going to be talking about what I think is 100%, not only with my opinion going to be my most passionate game out of all of his projects, like, I'm going to adore this shit, but I think it'll just genuinely be the best game he's made, because it looks clean, boys. So without further ado, let's just see what there is to see about this game. So scrolling all the way up into announcements, we've got Vryomancer talking about the fact that the game was in closed access. This was all the way like a month before I recorded this video, a little less, and the game was actually in a closed access testing phase during that time, but the game has been completely reworked since then. So they accepted a wave, waves people played, so some people have played this game. I was not one of them. Some stuff went down. They decided to make the game paid access in the future, so they didn't say how much this game is going to cost, but the game will be paid access in the future. It will not be free, but it will also not stay closed community the whole time. So, yeah. Alright, so we're moving on to the first sneak peek, which is of a ship in the ice poles where, you know, the waterbenders come from. Not sure which one. But it looks clean. It's just normal-ass sailing, but it looks nice. Look at that environment. The mountains over there, giant area. You can clearly see they've got a naming scene going on, so it's going to be a little bit, not necessarily roguelike, but, you know, different. Alright, this next one shows off a little bit more of the sailing. This one he's on his own on the ship, and you can see a little bit more of the amazing environment. Just nice lighting and shit. It looks good. And that's before the game was even reworked. Then we've just got a picture of a dock. And you can clearly see that this is, like, the way there. There's numbers down here, or whatever this is. I'm not sure what that is. You can see his move. Traditional little speed thing. You got money down here. I'm pretty sure this has all been a little reworked, but it was the original look of the game. So, now we've got what I believe is the funniest of the things that were shared. Just watching somebody get knocked to fall damage. But look at the environment. I love this. It just looks so nice and clean, honestly. So then they got us on April Fool's pretending that there was going to be a stress test. I totally fell for this, if you couldn't tell. And then it happened, and I was very sad. Then this is where it started to get good. He started to actually show off the moves. Now this is where the game got really exciting for me. Alright, so the game isn't as laggy as some of this footage makes it out. This is just how the sneaks are shown. But this shows a little bit of the melee combat and the old form of a water move. They've been reworked since. You'll see the later ones soon. But he clearly walked up to buy some cabbages from the cabbage man, who was clearly here, and beat the crap out of Kaiozai over here. Next we got a gif of Kaiozai getting him back as he knocks him off a boat, and you see how fast the boats really go as he gets, like, thrown way out there. Also, look how dark it is at night. This is going to be very interesting to navigate. So, he was talking about what needs to be done before a stress test is released here, and in doing so, he basically confirmed that he was going to revamp the moves, so that's not the same. The waters in the game are not going to be the same as that water move you guys already saw. But there's also going to be two quests for each area, which means this could change, this could easily change, but this means there are 100% straight up quests in the game, or at least some form of quest that he can call a quest, and trainers. So, also I suppose it's worth mentioning that he is resetting the stats from the testers that had it a long time ago when it first released, like almost a month ago. So, you know, we're all going to be on an even playing field if you get on a stress test. Okay, this is when things really started getting good. Pro bending was talked about, but we're not just there yet. That's going to be at the end of this video, and it's going to be the best part of the video, if you ask me. We now go into the update screen, where we can see one simple thing, and that is just a punch. This was the first sneak peek shown of the game, but you can see it's a beautiful environment. Look at that nice river. Just, this world looks great. He also said more about the revamps, and there's a JoJo meme. This is the part you've all been waiting for, the sneak peek channel, where he really shared some stuff. So first of all, we can see the actual ice pole and some kind of NPC trainer or something out here, and it just looks wonderful. Next, some kind of fire temple on an island. Also looks nice, but I mean, all we really have to judge is the temple here, so not a lot on gameplay, but it looks awesome. A little bit more shots of the beautiful landscape we were talking about in the previous shots. Look at that. It clearly shows there's going to be some kind of light parkour system. At least double jumping or something. And if not, you're going to have to travel like a very specific path, because this is very mountainous. Down here we've got the air temples. The southern air temple, if I remember correctly. I'm not certain. But freaking awesome. Could look a little better, if I'm being honest, but still awesome. Over here, I believe this is an earthbending guy? I can't be certain, but it's just another dock and an interesting-looking guy with a Luffy hat. Then they added the dreaded fog, where you can't see anything in the distance, which will make sailing, well, rough, but it'll be fun, if you ask me. Next up, we got a tiny peek at clothing and accessories. Looks like Earth Kingdom stuff. If you had the money, I guess you'd just click on this and you'd get it. Yep, see? Now this is where it got really exciting for me. For those who are curious on how water bending works. In the game, there's going to be pouch refilling. And you have to be near a water source to water bend, or have a pouch where you can constantly use the water and refill. This is what it looks like. This is still with the old non-revamped water too, so it looks even cleaner now. Frickin' awesome. I love it. Oh, but trust me, we haven't even gotten to the good stuff of the gameplay. This is just the base mechanics. Then we got a picture of what it looks like sailing. Just foggy hell. Then we have a picture of the Cabbage Man that even further confirmed the Cabbage Man is in the game. Then we got some kind of spirit oasis picture. So, you know, some kind of spiritual place in the game. And then we finally got bisons. What is this, man? What did they do? Oh, man. It's so fucking hilarious. Also, this is what nighttime looks like, so good luck. It's gonna be dark. Now, I'll be honest with you boys. Waterbending was never my favorite in the show. I don't know really what is, but it definitely wasn't waterbending. It was cool, but I wasn't that into it. I would never say I wanted it. But I 100% want that waterbending in this game. And it's just because it looks so clean. Look at this. It looks clean as fuck, okay? This is the revamped water. Did you see that shit, boys? Look at that again. Clear as shit. Moving on, we got to see something else amazing. And this is gameplay amazing. Did you see that? The moves are aimable. And according to Envied, most of the moves are aimable. So, mid-movement, he just turned that fireball and hit that guy. That's freaking awesome. A demonstration of, yet again, the movement and how much more it can be used. This time with a different set of moves where he fires 4 fireballs. Imagine the damage that combo. Then we have what looks to be the revamped water whip style move in the game. So let's see how clean that looks, because the water looks clean. Look at this. Pulls up that clear water, just smack. Gone. It's perfect, man. I'm not asking for any more. It's amazing. And then there was water's first controllable move, which looks even cleaner. I don't know what it is about seeing actual water just flying around in a controlled way like that, but it feels like actual bending it that way. It's just awesome. And he's pulling it out of a river. Then randomly mixed in with the water stuff, we just got the first earthbending move to be seen, which was him just firing some rocks. This early on, it really didn't look that good, especially because you could kind of tell the hitboxes were a little wonky, but I can assure you, they got better. Then we got a new skill with the water that they actually dropped the name of in the sneak peek. This is a water spear, and it looks really good. It's got crazy range, it looks strong, it looks like it's going to be awesome. Look at this. They clearly used the... Oh no, they used the river. I thought they were using their pouch. But look how far that hit. They hit all the way into that mountain over there. Look at that again. That's so crazy. Look at that distance. Then we got what is a pretty interesting concept. They announced that Pro Bending from Legend of Korra was going to be a mechanic in the game. It's not going to be open all the time, but certain people will be able to host it, and then you'll be able to do 1v1 or 2v2 Pro Bending. At least I think that's the rules. I'm not certain on the full extent of it, but I know 1v1s are a thing. And this is what the arena looks like. Could be better, but it looks freaking awesome, okay? At night especially, or whenever this is in the dark, it looks awesome now. Then they showed the true meaning of Pro Bending. This is where the potential of fighting really got shown. Look at that! He built a little defense. They tried to use water bending to hit them. The water bending splashes against this wall. You can barely see it. But he freaking launches the rock and just moves it mid-fight. Yeah, you could see that water splash effect. I think it actually hits him. I'm not sure. But I know that wall was great. That's just... This makes me so excited. Think about what could be done with this. Then we got more. This time, waterbender. Trying to attack, but missing. Looking accurate when they miss, too. Then this, with the caption that the art of pro-bending is being creative. Look at that. Two stone walls set up over the course of the fight. And then they use them to their advantage and bend a stone and hit them all the way around that. This is going to be so tactical and hard to do, but it's going to be awesome. I don't think there's a game on Roblox I'm any more excited for right now, or really anything right now. Then this was captioned, "When they annoy you," because he's basically just stunlocking this freaking waterbender, which is a little rough, but it's freaking awesome, okay? It looks awesome. Then one of the final things announced in sneak peeks, this was announced just yesterday, some areas will have debris in front of them, which means basically, on certain servers, there will be debris covering areas of the map so that players can't get there, and an earthbender has to move them for anybody to access it. And the ability will look like this. So, you see all this debris here? Imagine that's covering some piece of the map. This is what he'd be able to do. As an earthbender, you could just pick him up, throw him away. I'm assuming you can use this as a weapon, too. Then they showed off a sweet little earth combo, which really demonstrates how much it got worked on, because the hitboxes are clearly much cleaner with them actually hitting what they're supposed to hit here, for the most part. Then they showed us yet another water move, a new one apparently. Just this tiny little splash in front of them. And a longer one. I don't fully get it, but it looks freaking awesome, okay? After that, we got him using some quick sprays of water. Well, her, I suppose, but I know the player's that guy. And it just looks freaking awesome. Sorry that I've sped through these, but then the final thing is... I actually haven't seen this one. This is what bending looks like right now in the game as they're working on it. It's a little bit choppy. It's not in the game that way, but it's just the way they uploaded the footage. But it looks clean as hell. Like, you can see the water destroying his earth at midair at the end there, and then right there at that point. And you can see him hit him and fly back. This just looks freaking awesome. I don't know if I could be any more excited. I need it in my life. Stress test needs to drop. So yeah, then they were announcing that they're... is going to be the Pro Bending, the Airbending, I'm sorry, not the Airbending, yeah, Pro Bending games. And basically, this is going to be where it's always just let them fight in peace, you know? whoever's fighting, they're fighting in peace. There's no passing the half-court line. It's all about triggering the plates in the back, just like in the show. And because of knockback reasons, just like in the show, airbenders aren't going to be allowed, which may or may not change in the future. I am for it, but I know from a balanced perspective, a lot of people are complaining. So we'll see what Envied and Eternal do about that. So yeah, guys, I know that was quite a lot to digest, and I sped through it a bit, but it still took us some time. I really just wanted to show you guys off this game, because I am so hyped for this right now. If you guys want to join the Discord, so you guys will be alerted when the Well, guys, that was a bit quick and sped through, but we covered a lot, and it still took us quite some time. So, without further ado, I'm going to get to the end here. If you guys want to play this game or hear more information as information comes out, be sure to join the Discord left right at the top of the description for the game. My Discord is also down there. Don't get them confused, but if you want to join both, go ahead and do that. I really just wanted to build hype for this game because I am super excited for this game. And you guys know, day one of the stress test, I will be releasing a video on it. The stress test should be dropping any day now, and could even be out by the time this video is out. I hope not. But I am absolutely excited for it, and I just wanted to make sure more people know of this amazing-looking game. Anyways, guys, if you liked this video, be sure to hit that like button. If you really liked this video, be sure to smash that subscribe button. And as always, remember...